Yesterday, I was talking about the big question of, do you know what you want? Some people don't know what they want. They don't ask themselves that question. And it really keeps them stuck. When you don't ask yourself what you want, then you're never going to get it. And there's lots of reasons that we like flick that question away. It's hard sometimes to know what we want, but I got a question. What do you do when you know what you want? When you finally sit down and you engage with, what do I want? And you make the big long list, and some of it feels really far away, and others of it you don't know how you're going to make it happen. Like, what do you do when that's the scenario? And this is one of my clients who I'm speaking to you, Jamie. Because when you know what you want, that's very powerful right there, because that's the awareness piece. And most of us walk around unaware all the time. So I always say the first step is awareness. And then what? Well, then we need to normalize what's on that list. And this happens slowly, which is really frustrating for people, because you're like, okay, I've decided I want this. Let's go get it. Let's make it happen. And there's going to be a whole bunch of shit that gets in the way. I call it life getting lifey. And if you're not patient about that, the struggle will be way harder. It'll feel like you're, you know, pulling somebody up a mountain with you. So you have to be patient, which is very difficult to do. But here's the secret strategy. You have your list. You know what you want. Now we need to normalize what's on that list. And what I mean by that is, you're looking at your list and you're like, oh God, that's some crazy shit that I want. That's like, who am I to want that stuff? It's not normal to you yet. It might be new because you haven't made it happen. You don't know how to make it happen. You don't even know if you deserve to make it happen, right? So let's start to normalize it. Let me give you an example. About 4 years ago, I had just had enough with the weather in Syracuse. And I said to my husband, I don't know how, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I cannot be in Syracuse from like October to May and not see the sun. I need to get out of town. And I want to get out of town once a month and go see the sun. And now we have friends who live in sunny places. We have family who live in warm places. Like, this isn't that huge of a leap. I'm not saying like, let's go to like the spa and let's go to these fancy resort hotels. Like, I just needed to get out of town. And also, it was just me. Like, nobody else in my family struggles with this. And my husband looked at me and he was like, I don't know about that. Like, you know, we're not like loaded. Who do you think you are to kind of go away all the time? It wasn't normalized yet. But my first thing I said was, this is what I want. And then the more I talked about it with people, the more normal it became. There were definitely some people like, who do you think you are? How are you going to do that? How are you going to afford that? Like, there were definitely some of the negative chatter people, but a lot of people were like, oh my God, can you imagine? That would be amazing. Where do you think you'd go? What would you do? What would that look like? And the more I started to talk about it, the more it normalized my want. And I think what we do with ourselves is we have a want and then we don't look at it again. We maybe put it on a piece of paper. We're like, oh my God, that's so crazy. Who am I to want that? And we like shove it back in our journal and don't open it again. Or we've told somebody and we've gotten a negative reaction. Like, oh my God, how are you going to make that happen? Do you know how much that's going to cost? That's going to take forever. And then we like shove it back down. So we don't even have the benefit of giving ourselves room to breathe and grow and explore and normalize the thing. Let's go back to my example about traveling. I'm at the point where, just based on the friends that I have and the family I have and my propensity for traveling, I'm gone about 1 week every month. And sometimes it's a little vacation. Sometimes it's visiting family. Sometimes it's visiting a friend. But like, I get to go see the sun. In fact, in the summer, I actively choose not to go anywhere and not travel because I like to be in Syracuse because it's actually, this is the 3.5 minutes we get where it's actually sunny. So it has become normalized to my friends, to my family, to my husband and my son that I travel very frequently and I go see what I need to see. So if you don't engage with what you want, it seems weird. It's not normal yet. So how can we normalize what you want? Well, the first thing is engage with it all the time. And if you don't have somebody you can talk to about it, then you have to start writing about it. You have to start telling yourself what you want. And I'm pointing over here because this is where my journal is, and I write in it every day and then I fold the page over and I talk about what I want. And in fact, I am doing a challenge with my clients this month, like a intentional manifestation challenge. Like, what do you want? And let's attend to it every single day so we can normalize it and make it happen. And I've got them doing strategy so that every single day they spend no more than 5 minutes engaging with what they want. Are you doing that? And I remember back to when I was, this is before I was a business owner, and maybe this is where you are now, or you are a business owner and you want to get to the next place in your business. And you're like, oh, I want it to be, you know, I want to make, I don't know, mid six figures, and I want to travel, and I want to not be a slave to my business, and I want to be able to spend time with my family. Those are the things I want. And that's lovely. That's very specific. And you deserve to have that. I want to wake up in the morning and know what to do in my business. Absolutely, you do. You should have that. You deserve that. I want to have time in with my business and time in with my friends and family. You should have that. You should not be a slave to your business. I completely agree with that 100%. But if you're not engaging with that want clearly, specifically, all the time, it's going to just be in the ethers, and it's not going to feel normalized to you. So let's go back to before I was an entrepreneur. I was a teacher. And teachers, man, they have it hard. People like expect them to do so much and pull the kids up so far. And it's a lot of work. If you've never been a teacher, you don't know, but it's a lot of work. And you are constantly told what you should be doing, and you get handed a paycheck, right? So to make the leap to entrepreneurship is terrifying. And I knew what I was doing as a teacher. I did not know what I was doing as an entrepreneur. And so when I said, I think I want to start a business with my two partners, you know, it was my trainer and my best friend, and we wanted to start this business together. And I was like, I'm crazy. Who am I to do this? Like, I'm a freaking teacher. I'm not an entrepreneur. My husband's an entrepreneur. He should do that. I shouldn't do that. It wasn't yet normalized to me that I could be something different. And that might be where you're stuck right now. So until I became an entrepreneur and did the scary thing and engaged with myself, like now I see myself as an entrepreneur and I don't feel like an imposter saying it out loud, but I had to normalize it for myself. Are you doing that? Are you engaging with what you want on a very serious level? Like, so, you know, like I asked on my Instagram stories, what do you want? Can you answer this question? And I got things like peace, happiness, success. Like, yes, we all want that. But what specifically is going to bring you peace? What specifically is going to bring you happiness? What specifically is going to bring you success? And if you're not really engaging with it specifically and frequently, it's just going to remain in the ethers. So to answer the question, what if you got a big giant list and you don't know how, and you don't know which one, and you can't possibly see it yet? Then my suggestion to you is engage completely, specifically, frequently, until you get to the point where you know that it's possible. You believe that it's possible, and then answers just start coming left and right, and you can't even believe it. Now, if you find this helpful, you might want to attend my workshop. I'm giving an in-person workshop in Syracuse in the 17th of July. And it's all about how to grow your business. So if you're somebody who feels stuck and you're spinning and spinning and spinning, and like these are the kinds of questions that torture you, this workshop is going to help you clarify a whole bunch of things. And it's not a workshop where I'm talking at you or selling at you. It's actually a workshop where you're going to work through some shit. So I'm going to drop the link below. But if you like this kind of content, I have committed to showing up here every day for July. And my name is Jen Liddy. I'm a business development coach, and I hope to see you back here soon. Bye.